Hello children, how are you? I hope everyone is fine. Are you waiting for me? Yes, obviously. Okay, let we start your next chapter, that is whole number. Before going to the actual topic, let me discuss about your known concept, that is none other than predecessor and successor. Can you say the predecessor of 5? Yes, that is 4. Can you say the successor of 5? That is 6. Then what is meant by predecessor and successor? One number more than the given number called its successor. One number less than the given number called its predecessor. Then can you say the successor of 99? Yes, that is 100. And the predecessor of 99 is 98. Now you can observe here few example. Write the predecessor and successor of given number. First number I have taken, that is 19. Predecessor of 19 is 18. Successor of 19 is 20. Then predecessor of 1997 is 1996, successor is 1998. Predecessor of 12,000 is 11,999, successor of 12,000 is 12,001. Predecessor of 49 is 48, successor of 49 is 50. Predecessor of 1 lakh is 99,999, successor of 1 lakh is 1,01,001. Then I hope you understood about predecessor and successor. Still more example you have to solve. Next let me go for actual topic, that is whole number. Then what is meant by whole number? Before going to the whole number, let us discuss few points, that is now can you count these markers? How many markers are there in my hand? Can you guess? Yes, obviously you will start counting from 1, that is 1, 2, 3. How many markers are there? There are 3 markers. Then if I say count number of people in your home means what you are going to do? Obviously we will begin from 1. Then you are begin to 1, 2, 3 in this way. Then what are these numbers we are going to call? These numbers are occurring naturally. So for this number we are going to call what? Natural numbers. Now can you see here natural numbers? Natural numbers are all counting numbers are called natural numbers. What are the numbers we are going to use for count? That all numbers we are going to call what? Natural numbers. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 till infinite. Here infinite represent that there is no end for that numbers. There is no end for that numbers. By seeing natural numbers, next we will move on to whole number. Then what is meant by whole number? Can you see in this bowl? Can you count number of marble in this bowl? Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You written 5. Next, can you count number of marbles in this bowl? Then you have begun to think. Then what is the mathematical symbol is used to represent the empty bowl? That is none other than what? 0. That is none other than 0. 0 number of marbles are there in this bowl. Now natural numbers including 0 we are going to call whole numbers. Natural numbers including 0 we are going to call what? Whole numbers. Next you can see here the natural numbers along with 0 form the collection of whole numbers. The natural numbers along with 0 form the collection of whole numbers. Example 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 till infinite numbers we are going to call what? Whole numbers. Now next we will move on to number line. You know that in the previous classes you have performed the so many operations, that is none other than addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Now you are going to perform the operation on number line. Then what is meant by number line? Let we see number 9. Now you can see here I draw one line and we have to mark the starting point, that is 0. The right of the 0 we are going to write 1. The distance between 0 and 1 is we are going to call unit distance. The distance between 0 and 1 we are going to call what? Unit distance. Now next we have to mark the point 2 at the right of the 1. Then the distance between the 1 and 2 is also a unit distance. The distance between the number we have to take same distance and we have to mark the numbers on the number line. First we are going to mark 0 On the right side of the 0, we are going to mark 1. Right side of the 1, we are going to mark 2. The right side of the 2, we are going to mark 3. So on, we are going to mark the numbers. Now you can observe here, the right side of the number is increasing in order. The left side of the number is in decreasing order. If you go to the right side, you are going to get successor. If you come to the left side, you are going to get predecessors. Now, I hope you understood about number line. Next, we will move on to operation on number line. You have performed an operation means that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division by using numbers. Now, we are going to perform the operation on number line. First, we are going to discuss about what? Addition. Now, addition. First example I have taken here, that is add 3 and 4 on number line. Add 3 and 4 on number line. We know that already we have learned about number line. I have drawn here one number line. You can see here I have marked the numbers from 0 to 10 on the number line with unit distance. The distance between the number must be equal. With unit distance we have to mark the numbers. Now we can observe here we have to add 3 and 4. First we have to move up to 3. First jump. Up to 3 units we have to take. Now for 3 we have to add 4. We have to add means we have to go right side of the number. We have to jump right side of the number. Now you can see here I am going to jump 4 units from the right side of the 3. 4 units from the right side of the 3. Then what happening? 1, 2, 3, 4. The jump will end at the point 7. Now, therefore, the sum of 3 plus 4 becomes what? The sum of 3 plus 4 becomes what? 7. In this way, we are going to add the given numbers on the number line. Now, we can observe here 1, 2, 3. We have taken here 3 units and next we have taken 4 units. 3 units and 4 units if had means you are going to get how much? 7. Therefore, the sum of 3 and 4 becomes what? 7. Next, in the same way, I am going to take one more example, that is add 2 and 6 on number line. We have to add 2 and 6 on number line. Now, first we have to take how many units? 2 units. First, we will take 2 units. 1, 2. 1, 2. Now, what we have to do? We have to add. Then, we have to move right side or left side? We have to move right side. Now, how many units we have to move right side? 6 units we have to move right side. Then what happening? You can see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 units I have moved right side. Now, then the sum of 2 and 6, what you are going to get? That is 8. The sum of 2 and 6, what you are going to get? You are going to get 8. Therefore, the sum of 2 and 6 is how much? 8. Now, we can see here, first we have considered 2 units. For 2 units, we are going to add how many units? We are going to add 6 units. Then, you are going to get how many units? That is 8. In this way, you are going to add numbers on the number line. I hope you understood, children. In the next class, I will explain about subtraction on number line, multiplication on number line. If you have any doubt, you can ask children. Thank you. Bye-bye.